Hi everyone, so this is my first commented video for ImagineFX and I hope you will enjoy it. I will try to comment on the most interesting or important parts of my working process. As the workshop concentrates on lighting, I am starting off with an already painted basis. I will be showing you the key elements of painting this image, such as defining the facial features and applying lighting effects, as well as painting in some of the textile. As you see, always when starting out, I am working with highly transparent brushes. My opacity pretty much never goes above 50%. The reason behind it is rather obvious, I believe. Well, applying colors gradually lets me control the outcome as I proceed. As you can observe on the video, applied changes can be very hard to notice. Like here, you see my brush moving, but barely any changes visible. Well, painting to me is all about those small changes. They are the ones that create the essence of the final effect. For early definition stages, such as now, I prefer to bounce around between different elements to ensure that everything is developed correctly. And only for final detailing stages, I am splitting the process and working on everything part after part. To be perfectly honest, I don't always keep to my palettes. I enrich them as I go on. As you see here, I am eyedropping the blocked in colors, not the ones from the palette. It guarantees me smoother blending, and I let the colors develop. I eyedrop from the palette mainly when I want to introduce a new shade on top of the existing coloring. To define the face's context a bit more, I am right now sketching in some of the hair, just to give the overall a little bit of detail. Okay, so I had the face basically defined, and right now I'm moving on to painting the body. Just like before, I am first blocking in some huge brush strokes, very transparent, just to give the sketch a bit more realistic feel. Even though the workshop was split logically, basically my workflow is more natural, and so you can see me blocking different types of highlights and shadows at the same time. None of the brushes is that good on its own, so I am constantly bouncing around two brushes, the rect hard round one and the airbrush. I first am blocking some basic colors and blending them roughly, but smoothing everything with a transparent airbrush. everything is looking quite realistic now. I am just fixing some shadows and adding some extra highlights here and there. I also have to fix the edges because the borders between the character and the background aren't solid. Okay, so considering the flesh somewhat done in terms of light depiction, I am right now moving on to defining the textile. I am applying some basic shadows and basic highlights, but nothing too fancy for now. If you, like me, ever feel your brush strokes are too messy, you can try to use Photoshop's Median filter. It makes those half-transparent brush strokes look much more solid and in general creates a more realistic result that just needs some detailing. Okay, so this part is pretty much drawing to an end, so please check the second video to see the detailing stage.